So, good afternoon to everyone, and thanks a lot for the invitation. I'm really happy to be here and to be part of this conference. I was been in Japan something like 10 years ago, and it was a really good experience there. I meet some of the Japanese community guys, and it was a really pleasure to me. So, I'm here to introduce the next Phosphor G conference. I'm here, really happy to be able to host this wonderful conference in Italy next year. And so let's see. So what is Phosphor G? Most of you should know. It's an international conference about the free and open source geographic software. It's the same conference that you are doing today, but in the international and the worldwide scale. It's based on 2 days of workshop and 3 days of presentation. And usually at the end, there are 1 or 2 days of code sprint or community sprint where people can meet and improve the software. It's a long story behind this conference. Everything starts officially in 2006 in Lausanne, but there was two conferences before that was the birth of Phosphor G. One was in Trento and the other one was in Bangkok, where the GRASS and MapServer community joined for the first time. And after that, there was a really long history of conference later named Phosphor G. It is worldwide, so we travel around Europe, North America, Asia, Africa, and finally this year we should move to Buenos Aires, but this was not possible since COVID restriction and all the problems related. As you can see, the conference increased a lot the number of participants. And in the last 3 or 4 edition, we always get more than 1,000 people attending the conference. And obviously this year that it was online and with really cheap cost to be a participant, we got a really big number because I wrote like 1,500 people, but probably there was more than. So next year we'll be in Florence, Firenze. And Firenze is one of the most beautiful city in Italy and the world. He was the birthplace of Renaissance. So you can find here the most famous artist of the medieval period. And there was a lot of really wonderful places. You can see some of the these places like the Ponte on the Arno or the Michelangelo's artwork and the beautiful view of Florence during night. So it's Firenze is full of history. There are a lot of museum, great palace, beautiful church, and this is one something more that we can provide to the next Phosphor G participant. So this is the local committee. The local organizing committee is composed by people from research, from government, and also from private companies. We try to be more inclusive possible and to get a good balance between men and women. It's a little bit difficult sometimes, but we try to make our best. And all the people are from the Italian community, and they are really well, some of them are really well known also in the international community. For example, I think that some of you should know Andrea Antonello, that is the main developer of GeoPaparazzi and now it's Mesh. And with us, we have two companies that are helping us. So the Firenze Convention Bureau, it's a public company that is trying to bring conference and events in Florence. And we really need to thank them because they start to push to have the conference in Florence. they contact us and they really help us to make the proposal and to create this ecosystem behind the Fast4G conference. Instead, AIM is a professional conference organizer, and it's a company that they will help us to organize all the most important aspect of the conference. So this is the location. As you can see, we are able to host the conference in a really old palace, and where they was able to create this wonderful room with more than 1,000 people seats. And so we can combine the conference with the history of Florence. This is the other palace in front of the older. There is a new palace that we will use for the session, for the parallel session. And the last location that we will use is the University of Florence, and where we will keep the workshop and the code sprint. We should be able to host something like for more than 40 workshop and something like 300 talks during these 5 days. And so probably we will able to increase a little bit the number, because we are thinking to have some only online session, and so we can rent some more room for that. We will have four social events, or at least we plan to have four social events. One is it will be the icebreaker, that is the entry social event where people can speak and make jokes and something like that. On Thursday we will have the gala dinner. It will be close to the venue in another historical palace, the Fortezza del Basso. On the Friday evening we will have a Firenze visit. We will try to organize few different track. One, it will be for wine and food, since Italy is really well-named for food and drinks, and Tuscany is one of the most important places in Italy for these topics. One, it will be a city tour, so we will find a guide to bring you around the city. And the third one is the visit to the Observatory of Arcetri. Is close to the city center in the hills, and they already provide us some good information about the visit, and it's quite interesting for people coming from geospatial field. The last event will be the code sprint aperitif. So for all the participants to the code sprint on Saturday evening, there will be aperitif, and where they can relax and continue to speak on what to do the day after to improve their own software. Obviously, for running the conference and to try to keep the price lower as we can, we need some sponsor. We are going to release today or tomorrow the sponsorship level, but we can already tell you that we will have seven different level of sponsor. The diamond, it will be one or more sponsors that are the most important one. They will have some really good benefit, something like a track, yeah, one se a session, a parallel session during the conference, or a keynote speech or a workshop. The same for Platinum. Diamond can choose two between this opportunity. Platinum can choose only one of these three opportunity. And for the other level, most of them has obviously the logo on the website and on our social channel. We can send mail to the Fast4G attending contacts. That is something like more than 8,000 people that are reading these mails. And we have obviously some exposition places close to the venue or inside the venue. And according to the level of sponsor, you can get more or less spaces. And after, since we are in a really wonderful places for food and drinks, we have catering sponsor that they can help us to provide to the participant some of the Italian and Tuscany test. We have right now five social media accounts. We have a YouTube channel where we'll publish some video before the conference, and for the high level sponsor, they can also send us some video, a video, and we will publish on the channel. We have Twitter, that probably is the most used channel by the Fosfor G community. And we have Facebook, LinkedIn, and Telegram. Right now, Telegram is only a read-only channel, but we are thinking to move in the next time for also for discussion between the participants. And obviously, we have a website that is online since the final day of Fosfor G 2021. We are now putting new pages, but you can already get in touch with the 2022 fosforg.org website. And yeah, probably this is all the information that you need. We have emails account. So you can write to info@fosforg, or if you are interested to sponsor the conference, you can write to sponsor@fosforg.org, and we will answer as soon as possible. What I can tell you more is that we are really close to open the call for paper. Probably at the start of the next week, we will open it. We will have the general session that is for general topics, and there will be only an abstract review from the people. We will have an academic track that is more related to research. And for this track, we will have the first review of the abstract, and after you will have to send a full paper. The paper will be published on the on Easy book. Probably it will be the ESPRS archive. So also for researchers, this is a good opportunity. And all the to publish all this in the academic track, you will be registered. And for each registration, you can submit also two papers, not only one. So this is another good opportunity for academic person. So I think that's all. Domo arigato to everyone. And if there are any question, I am here to answer to the question.
Thank you very much. では質問を見てみましょうし、質問。I have one question. One of the attendee is asking, do you consider hybrid conference?
So yes, thanks for the question. I forgot to say this. Yeah, we are obviously considering, or we will do a hybrid conference, because right now we have not clear idea what will be the situation in August, and the staff are changing quite often, at least every couple of months there are some updates and news, and also the law are changing. But what we are thinking is to have the main conference on physical events, so in Florence. And if the law will not change, we will be able to host something like 600 people in Florence. That is not the full audience of Fosfor G, but it's a starting point for what I can say. And I hope that is in August there will be more or less restriction, so there will be able to host more people. And so, but obviously we know that the situation will be not as before COVID, so we have to think how to manage all the problems and all the strange situation that can happen in August. So the idea is to have some online session, a couple of only online sessions, so the people can stay abroad in their hometown and make the presentation. And for last minute problems, we will be able to stream a recorded video also in the general track. So the general and the academic track will be on presence, but at the last minute, some country cannot send people like South Africa right now. So people from South Africa cannot arrive in Italy, and but they could be able to make their own talk. The only problem in this situation is that we will not able to provide probably the question and answer time, because we have some technical problem probably, but at least the people can make their own presentation. So during the call for paper, there will be a question that is asking, if you already know that you will do online, please check this box, and at least we can understand how many people want to do the only online and to manage better the organization of the conference.
Okay, thank you. はい、ハイブリッドをカンファレンスにするということですけど、詳細については岩崎さん翻訳できますか？
It's okay. I will translate your comment, ルカさん。詳細にはなんか私もとか聞きながらやってたので、あれなんですけれども、まあ、すべてのカンファレンスオンライン、オフラインでできない可能性もあるので、ものによってはハイブリッドオンリーのものも、開催しますよということでした。で、その場合でも、まあ、600人ぐらいは、まあ、ちょうどそこで、まあ、いいや。600人ぐらいは、フィレンツェの会場に集まって、残り、まあ、ハイブリッドみたいな形、オンラインで、やるみたいなことも考えていられるということです。ただ、600人というのは、初めの放送時が始まった時にはこのぐらいの、規模感だったので、まあ、それはそれでいいんじゃないのかなというお話でした。で、まあ、その他、現状、南アフリカから、人が入ってこれないとか、そういった問題も発生してたりとか、まあ、テクニカル、その他もろもろ技術的な問題もたくさんあったりするので、まだ今後いろいろ考えていくことはあるんだろうなというようなお話でございました。もし翻訳しようとしていることがあったら、どなたかコメントお願いします。はい。
あとオンラインで参加することがもう決まってるんだったら、なんかチェックしてもらえると、
オンライン専
用ということでしたね。
うん、はい。ということです。
ですかね。はい。
ありがとうございました。
はい。
その、Any other comment or question?
Okay, for me, so how many people are preparing or running this event? So preparing for this such a great event, so it must be very hard to...
Yeah, so as you can see on the slides upstairs here, we have something like 25 people or something more. Obviously, not all are working deeply in all the aspects. So we have several committees, and I try to have a co-chair committee. So all the committees is chaired by two people. So if something appear or for some meeting, one is not possible to attend, the other one. And he should know or she should know everything about the committee, and she can report to the local committee. And what I can tell you is that we start in 2018 to work on that.
Oh.
So 3 years ago, and this was a good moment because there was not COVID yet.
Yeah.
And because with the situation right now, I don't think that we will start to organize a such big conference.
Mm-hmm.
Instead, we was the only one that applied for the next year conference, and there was open also to US, not only to Europe, because Phosphor G has this cycle. 1 year is in the Europe, the other one is in North America, and the third one is around the world. And since there was just one application, there was a requirement for also from North America people to send some application, but there was none. And so who is working deeply? I think that is something like 15 people, really deep, or around 15 people. And obviously I'm supervising everything, or most of the stuff, and I try to be updated on all the different topics. We also with Maria, the previous chair of Phosphor G 2021, we are working to bring some technical stuff managed by OSGEO. For example, this year the call for paper will be provided by Pretax. That is the same software that was used by 2021 conference, but is installed on OSGEO server. So this means that we had not to take care about it, and there are some people that is taking care to the installation and the configuration. And the really important part of this topic is that we are able to provide this infrastructure also for the local chapter. So if you are interested for the next year conference, you can manage the call for paper using this talks.osgeo.org. That is a pre-tag instance. And so I think that this is really useful for everyone, and also for the next Phosphor G organizer.
Thank you.
中川さん、ご自分でトランスレート。まあ、25人とか15人とか、それぐらいの人々が主にやられていて、まあ、サーバーとかのインフラ系はあるので、結構、うちは強いんだよみたいなことを、ざっくり言うとそういうお話でしたかね。
はい、ありがとうございます。
I have a quick question. So you say that only the 15 people is coming, 15, only 15 people is preparing this kind of the big conference. I'm very surprised. And
not only 15 are working deeply.
So that I have a question. Deeply means how many percentage of committed or Phosphor G conference? 100% or the 50% of his or her work?
Okay, right now is not daily work. It's like more weekly work. And especially there are some specific tasks to do in specific moment. Right now we are working deeply on the sponsor and the call for paper. So for example, people working on travel grant or volunteering are not working deeply now. For example, we have also a big help from the PCO. For example, all the proposal was written by the PCO and the Convention Bureau from Florence with the venue. And we just add some information about the program and some stuff related only for Phosphor G, not to the general application. We had a sprint during the day of Phosphor G 2021, because we was working on the website and on the video. So on 1 week we prepared the video, and that time was really hard, because we had to record that video and send to the people editing it. In a couple of weeks we need to start to think about the registration and so people from the PCO and people from the local committee and program committee should work a little bit more. And I think that the most demanding part is the 2 months before the conference. And for that, and also during the registration, there will be a lot of questions and so on. But for that, fortunately, we have the PCO guys that they will manage this part. And also the social media people are working quite often. But for example, we had now 2 weeks that we had no really big news, so they was relaxed. And from this day, they have to start again to work because we have the sponsor out, the call for paper out. And so, yeah. But 20 people should be the start, I think, for organize the conference. With less than 20 people, it's quite difficult to start, I think.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, and after we are for the program committee, we have also people around the world that will review the abstract and the paper that are submitted. And for that, we are thinking about 40 people for each, for the general track and 40 for the academic track.
Thank you very much. So, ちょっとコメントすると、deeply って言ってるけど、どれぐらい deeply なんですかっていうお話なんですけど、聞いてみたんですけど、それは仕事の内容によって、時期によっていろいろ変わってくるよというようなお話でした。で、具体的には、2週間、2ヶ月ぐらい前になってくると、やっぱり、そのプログラムの編成だとか、SNS の担当だとかっていうのが忙しくなってくるし、時期時期によって、いろいろな人が変わってきて、プログラムがなんかをやるとなると、やっぱり40人とかそういった人数が必要になってくるんじゃないんですかね、みたいなことを、おっしゃっておりました。ざっくり言うとそんな感じです。他に、クエスチョン、
can I add one more thing? Sorry?
Yes?
I just want to, because I know that there will be some OpenStreetMap contributor or advocate or something like that. So we are working to bring also the SOTOM, so State of the Map, and the OT Summit in Florence in the same days.
So here is so many... Here is also OpenStreetMap people in this conference. So that is very good news.
So we had a discussion on Thursday with Tyler from OTT, and they will give an answer by the start of the next year on January or February. And about SOTOM, we are preparing the application because they open the application until the end of the year. So we are in a good shape to send the application. We need to just to have the feedback from the venue, not from...
Yeah.
We will go to university because the venue for FOSG is quite expensive. And so the university is a little bit cheaper. And so you can take the ticket for SOTOM and OTT cheaper. So this is good news, I think, for OpenStreetMap contributor.
Yes, thank you very much. I think I'm also think so very good news, and maybe it is first information for us. Yeah, so that I'm very happy to invite you to make a presentation, a keynote speech in here. So. And other our colleagues and our community members is also very happy to hearing more detail of the FOSFOSI 2022. And I have last question: what is the most recommended place or things or food in the Firenze?
Oh, there are really a lot, and. So, meat is good.
Meat is good.
Wine is really good.
Yeah.
And the place is wonderful. It's really, we are trying to bring the conference there because it's all walking distance, so you have not to take any buses or stuff like that. And it's not so big city, it's a medium-sized Italian city. And so it's amazing. I'm not from Florence, but I'm going there quite often in the last year, and I really like it. And the venue is 2 minutes by the main train station. So also if you want to go somewhere in, for example, there are high-speed train, not like the Japanese high-speed train, but something like. And in a couple of hours, you can be in Rome or Milan. In 40 minutes, you are in Bologna. That is another really wonderful city. So it's really well connected. It's in the center of Italy, and you can move quite easily everywhere.
Yes, thank you very much. So, unfortunately, here comes the time limit. So that everybody, thanks again to Luca-san. Arigatou gozaimashita. Grazie.
Arigatou.
Luca-san, arigatou gozaimashita.